Hey, my name's Steve. Thanks for connecting with us. A little bit of a different video today, not your normal following the way video. We wanted to respond to a documentary that Netflix has recently brought out called The Social Dilemma. It's a full-on documentary, super challenging around social media and its design and how it's shaping, I guess, our minds into the future. And so we wanted to do a bit of a response from our point of view, from our followers of Jesus' point of view, and hopefully you find it informative. But first, what would really help is if you've seen the documentary. Now, we are going to show some snippets, some quotes, but if you haven't seen it, we'll encourage you to go see it. Pause, turn off the video, stop it where it is, and come back after you've watched it. So we'll let you do that now. And one of the things we were challenged by in this documentary is that the interviewers weren't just people's opinions or weren't just ideas that someone on the street had about social media. They were actually interviews with some of the inventors, some of the developers of some of the largest social media platforms here and now. And so we were deeply challenged by their ideas of social media, but their ideas of what it's doing to us and where it's going into the future. Now, we've already spoken about social media on this channel, and honestly, we're going to speak about it again. And these videos aren't, we're not so much anti-social media. After all, how hypocritical, you're watching this likely on social media. These are tools for either good or bad, depending on how it's used, how it's shaping us. The main thing we actually wanted to respond to or talk about or center this whole video on is this idea of truth. It's spoken a lot right through this documentary. They're circling around this concept of what is truth. To kick us off, here's a quote from a formal Google design ethicist, Tristan Harris, talking about this idea of truth.
If we don't agree on what is true, or that there is such a thing as truth, we're toast. This is the problem beneath other problems, because if we can't agree on what's true, then we can't navigate out of any of our problems.
Before we take a deeper dive into what is truth and this idea of truth, we need to first look at how this documentary explores how they actually got to this problem, how they found themselves in this problem. I, like the documentary makers, like the guys speaking on it, don't believe that when Facebook, Instagram were first getting designed on a computer, that anyone was thinking about totally evil intentions. After all, I love the way they talk about the like button. Originally being designed for sharing memories, sharing in the joy, connecting each other. I think, like the designers speak about, that these platforms have taken a life of their own, have gone to different places than their original intention.
I mean, there were meaningful systemic changes happening around the world because of these platforms that were positive. I think we were naive about the flip side of that coin.
Yeah, these things, you release them and they take on a life of their own, and how they're used is pretty different than how you expected.
These tools aren't evil in themselves, either were the creator's intentions. But as this documentary shows, hands change over, concepts change, and these tools can be used for such harm and destruction.
What's wrong in the tech industry right now? There's a cacophony of grievances and scandals, and they stole our data, and there's tech addiction, and there's fake news, and there's polarization, and there's some elections that are getting hacked. But is there something that is beneath all these problems that's causing all these things to happen at once?
When you look around you, it feels like the world is going crazy. You have to ask yourself, like, is this normal? Or have we all fallen under some kind of spell?
The documentary goes on to show that these ideas aren't just theories, that there's actually quantifiable data behind it. The research shows, comparing before 2009 and after 2009, when social media suddenly became available on phones, that there was a direct increase in suicides, showing girls between 14 to 19 going up by 70%. And girls between 10 to 14, teenagers, going up 151%. That is mind-boggling data, showing that there are real consequences. There's real devastation happening as a result of improper social media use. And it's not just young minds that are being manipulated or formed around social media. The research shows that these sensational, crazy, dangerous ideas, fake news, is spreading like wildfire, particularly because it's profitable, particularly because it gets the views, it gets the likes. But so does the dangerous ideas spread.
What we're seeing with COVID is just an extreme version of what's happening across our information ecosystem. Social media amplifies exponential gossip and exponential hearsay to the point that we don't know what's true, no matter what issue we care about.
Imagine a world where no one believes anything that's true. Everyone believes the government's lying to them. Everything is a conspiracy theory. I shouldn't trust anyone. I hate the other side. That's where all this is heading.
Everyone's entitled to their own facts. There's really no need for compromise, no need for people to come together. In fact, there's really no need for people to interact. We need to have some shared understanding of reality. Otherwise, we aren't a country.
So what's our solution? What's our response to this? Facebook creator Mark Zuckerberg's response is he believes it's found in AI or artificial intelligence. He thinks by examining data and more data and finding common patterns in people's thinking that we might be able to find what's crazy and what's on the extreme and then what's normal. Except common experience, research, and this documentary tends to suggest that won't work.
We are allowing the technologists to frame this as a problem that they're equipped to solve. That's a lie. People talk about AI as if it will know truth. AI is not going to solve these problems. AI cannot solve the problem of fake news. Google doesn't have the option of saying, oh, is this conspiracy? Is this truth? Because they don't know what truth is. They don't have a proxy for truth that's better than a click.
So back to the main concept or the reason we wanted to make this response video. This whole idea, as we quoted before, Tristan said that if we don't have absolute truth or we don't know what truth is, then we're toast. This whole idea of what is truth? This question of what is truth is something that ancient philosophers and modern scholars have debated over thousands of years. This idea that truth could be objective, that there's a hard and fast truth of the universe, or that truth could be subjective, that your truth is your truth, that my truth is based on my experiences, my truth. The problem is, if you say that there is no objective truth, only subjective truth, then you're thereby saying an objective truth, and your brain folds in on itself when you cause a black hole. Not really, but these ideas, you can see why these debates have been going on for so long. So then science will tell us that truth is only things we can observe, that we can prove off data or observation. But again, this falls apart when you can't observe it, when you can't prove it, when you have to talk about concepts like meaning and morality. So what is truth then? And how do we know it? How do we find it? Well, as we often do at Following the Way, let's have a look at Jesus' teaching, or in this scenario, let's have a look at a conversation he has to the governor while he's on trial, Pilate, about, you guessed it, truth. And Jesus said, in fact, the reason I was born and came into the world is to testify to the truth. Everyone on the side of truth listens to me. What is truth? Retorted Pilate. You see, Pilate didn't realize that Jesus had already answered this question previously. One of the most famous things, in fact, Jesus said is, I am the way, I am the truth, I am the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. What this means is Jesus is saying basically, yes, if there is a God, and if he is in control of everything, if he is our absolute truth, then he's going to be unfathomable. It is going to make our mind melt and implode. But Jesus is saying, I am the living, breathing example of God. I am a tangible way to follow absolute truth. You can follow me. Follow my way. And what this actually means is exactly what Jesus again says. He says, the truth will set us free. And following Jesus means freedom from our own ability to decide, because our own ability is often inclined towards evil. It escalates that way, as this documentary says.
When you think about technology and it being an existential threat, you know, that's a big claim. It's not about the technology being the existential threat. It's
the technology's ability to bring out the worst in society, and the worst in society being the existential threat.
If technology creates mass chaos, outrage, incivility, lack of trust in each other, loneliness, alienation, more polarization, more election hacking, more populism, more distraction and inability to focus on the real issues, that's just society. And now society is incapable of healing itself and just devolving into a kind of chaos.
And we couldn't agree more. These tools aren't the existential crisis. They're not evil in themselves. To be honest, it's us. Without an absolute direction, truth, without God, we believe we're slaves, slaves to our own depravity, slaves to our own greed. We'll mold these tools towards that. These tools become somewhat evil. Instead, we're, I guess, offering another road, another invitation, offering you to consider this truth found in the tangible work and ways and life of Jesus. That as the Bible says, a life lived in those ways can produce love, produce joy, patience, peace. A life that produces life, not destruction. So I guess the last part of our response, the last part of this invitation now to this Netflix documentary, The Social Dilemma, is a little bit of my own personal experience. And my own personal experience agrees completely with this documentary. As a father, as a husband, as a pastor, I have found that I have become increasingly distracted. I have found that social media sometimes completely distracts or takes away from my day. The hunger, the addiction, if you call it, from that notification on Facebook is so alluring to me. In fact, it's one of the reasons that I've got myself a conker, what they call a dumb phone, a basic phone, but that's for another video, another time. I'm currently journeying with that to help, control the way I use some of these tools. And I guess that's what this whole channel is about. The content we're producing is about finding that truth in Jesus and his ways. Whether you agree or disagree or just come in because you find it weird and wacky, we love you joining us. Hit subscribe, hit like, and we can't wait to see you on our next video as we continue to explore the ways of Jesus and how we follow them.